I'm about to show you muggles how it's done. What's good, pal, with Director Peeps? Today, I'm going to be bringing you the Harry Potter Invisible Cloak Effect using PowerDirector 17. If you're excited about using this Invisible Cloak Effect for your next video, I want you to put hashtag Harry Potter Love in the comment section below. Here we are in PowerDirector 17. The Invisibility Cloak Effect is one of the easiest special effects to make while adding significant value to your production. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to make the Invisibility Effect for your videos. Let's get invisi with it. You'll need to use a tripod to record two clips. A clip with the person pulling a cloak over their head and a clip with nothing in the scene. Don't move the tripod or camera in between recording these two scenes. They must be in the exact same position when recording each clip. If either one of them moves, you're going to jack up the effect. The clip of the person pulling the cloak over their head needs to be on track two. The cloak is two backgrounds being held together. A black background, which is going to be visible, covered by a green background, which will key out to make the person invisible. The clip with nothing in it needs to be on track one. This is the background that remains after we make the person invisible. Try to make the subject hold the background so that the black is showing at the beginning of the clip. We tried doing that for about 30 or so takes, and this was the best we could get. So deal with it. C'est la vie, baby. To start things off, you want to double click on the clip that is on track two to open up the PIP Designer. You're going to use the green part of the cloak to make the person invisible. But before you do that, I want to remind you to subscribe to PowerDirector University to see great tips and tricks just like this every Saturday. And if you subscribe, don't forget to click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. Now, let's get back to the breathtaking tutorial. You want to move the playhead to a position where the subject is completely covered by the green screen. Then you want to scroll down to Chroma Keyer, and you want to click on the carrot to open it up. Then you want to check the box next to Chroma Key to enable it. Then you want to click on the eyedropper tool. And you want to move the eyedropper tool to a section of the green screen that you want. And left click on that. And voila, it is disappeared. But it's not done yet. You're going to have to use your color range and step that up to a position that you like. Make sure everything looks good. And that looks really good right there. But if you move your playhead back to where you see the black and the green, you might see some parts that you don't like as much. And you might need to do a few more tweaks. On this one, let's move the denoise down. Let's move the denoise down to zero. I think that'll work right there. And now let's play this back to see what it looks like. It looks pretty good right there. Now you can make any additional adjustments or add additional keys if you think you need to do that. It's really up to you. And at this point, you want to go ahead and click on OK. Now when we move this forward, we can see there's still some outline going on the green screen. So we want to make sure that we remove that. What we're going to do is fade the rest of the cloak out of the scene to sell the effect a little bit better. So what we need to do is go to the transition room. Then you want to click on general. And then you want to grab the fade transition and drag that down to the end of the clip. Let it go. And that should help fade that out and sell the effect a little bit more. So let's play this back and see what it looks like. That's how you make the Invisibility Cloak Effect using PowerDirector 17. If you decide that you like PowerDirector 17 and you want to buy or upgrade to the software, I'll leave some links in the video description. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.